Well, most traditional people grow medicinal plants and medicinal associates and have natural medicine alternatives. They also govern the way they live, so they stay healthier. So here comes a large dog crashing through the bamboo sheath. There we go. Don't now underneath the tripod, rocking the camera. Okay, he's on his way. Now, it's about staying healthy rather than needing more medicine because you're living in an unhealthy way. So there's two transitions here. One towards natural medicine, but prior to that, the need to understand what it is to be healthy and wealthy with a good living, with the lack of requirement for money. So you don't need so much finance, you don't need so much assistance. You're living in a world that has an abundance of fresh air, an abundance of clean water, an abundance of clean food, an abundance of sensible housing, warmth, friendship, and community, and an abundance of time quality, and an extra time quantity. So with that, in a peaceful world, we have better health. Now, that's not to say some of the wonderful medicine today that we can access can't also be maintained, and we can work towards a system where some of those absolute necessities can be more natural-based, but also recyclable and reusable. So I myself have had to rely on quite a bit of pharmaceuticals to keep me going in some of these serious AIDS scenarios. I've had malaria twice, I've had cholera twice, I've had many, many different parasites. And my daughter has quite a bit of medical condition that we need to work with. So I'm very concerned about this situation, but I don't think it's beyond our capability to address it in a very beneficial way, a very sustainable way, and a very appropriate way. It's about design, of course, and it's not just the living systems, but it's the way we live in this world.